So welcome back, guys. Up until now, we have learned some basic CSS properties. And now let's move on to one very important concept in CSS known as CSS Box Model. So what exactly is CSS Box Model? According to CSS Box Model, every content that you add onto your HTML page is surrounded by three boxes. The first one of them is padding, the second is border, and the third is margin. So let's see this with the help of an example. So see this diagram on your screen. Suppose you have a paragraph on your web page, which is currently on the center of the screen. Now this paragraph has a background color of white, and as you can see, it is currently surrounded by three boxes. The first one is a yellow box, which is also called the padding. The second one is the border box, which is represented by black color. And finally, the third one is this blue colored box, which is the margin box. So using CSS, you can control all the three boxes to change the properties of a particular element. So let's see this using a demo. So let's come back to Sublime Text and let's create a new file inside Project 1 folder. And let's save it as boxmodeldemo.html. And let's quickly add the HTML tags. Head tag, which will have a title of box model demo. Let's add the body tag, which will contain, currently it will consist of two elements. The first one will be a h1, which will say box model demo. And the second one would be a paragraph, and we can just go to Google Chrome and go to the content generation website libsyn.com, and we can just copy some dummy text, not this much, like this much is enough. Control C and Control V. So now we have our paragraph text. That's great. Now let's go to the folder and let's load the page. So this is how our page looks like currently. Now let's do one more thing. In the head tag, let's link our CSS file, which is css/style.css. Save. Let's go back and reload. So as you can see, the background color is automatically turned into purple. Let's go to our CSS file, which is under CSS folder. And let's remove all the code and let's save this file. Now when we'll reload, it will come back to the original state. Now what we are going to do is we are going to handle the box properties of this particular paragraph. So first of all, let's add a background color of say yellow, like this. Save. Reload. And now as you can see that you have added a background color of yellow to your paragraph text. Now the next thing that we are going to do is we are going to add a border so that you can actually see the border which was previously invisible. So to add a border, you add a border like this. You specify the width of border, you give it a color. In our case, it will be #000000. This is the hex code for black color. And finally, a word that is solid. So our border will be continuous, solid. Let's save this. And let's go back and reload the page. And now, as you can see that our paragraph text has a border. So now, let's understand what is padding and what is margin. So before margin, let's understand what is padding. Let's go back to the original diagram. As you can see, currently our text looks like this. The difference or the distance between the border and the content is known as padding. So over here, the distance between our text and the border will be the padding. So currently it's very, very small. Let's write some code to increase the padding. So to increase the padding, we'll write 5 pixels. What this will do is it will automatically add 5 pixels at top, bottom, right and left. Save. And now when you reload, now you can see you have added a padding of 5 pixels to your paragraph text. You can also do something like this. You can add individual top, bottom, right and left padding to your paragraph, or generally to any HTML element. Let's reload this, and as you can see, we have added a 15 pixels padding to our paragraph text. Now let's understand what is margin. In our diagram, when you see the distance between the border and the screen is margin. So in our case, when we go back, this distance is margin. This distance is margin. But in the case of top, the margin will be calculated from the next top element. And in the case of bottom, the next bottom element. So let's do one thing. Let's increase the margin of this particular element by writing margin 25 pixels. What this piece of code will do is, it will automatically add 25 pixels to all the four sides like this. This is how you add margin to your elements. You can individually control the margin too, so you can write it like this. Let's add a margin top of 225 pixels. So what it will do is that it gives you a difference or a distance of 225 pixels between the current element and the next element, which is at its top. So this is how you can individually control the alignment or the placement of elements on your web page.